Hi folks, welcome back. So today's reaction video is going to be for an artist called Aurora. The song is called Runaway. So this isn't an artist I've ever heard before. So this is going to be, I really don't know what I'm going in for here at all. And if you're new to the channel, just a quick disclaimer, I purposefully did not research anything before I listen, so I can get complete element of surprise with everything. The idea is to get as much of an unbiased reaction as possible here. So let's see what this one's all about. Without further ado, after 3, 2, 1, go.
I was listening to the ocean. I saw a face in the sand, but when I picked it up, then it vanished away from my hands. I had a dream. I was 7, climbing my way in a tree. I saw a piece of heaven waiting in patience. And I was running
really like this. This is really ethereal. Beautiful production on this with the vocals. It's reminded me of several different things. You've maybe heard of a French artist called Camille. Her vocals are astounding as well. It also has like a modern day, there's a bit of a Billie Eilish thing going on, although this looks like it's predates Billie Eilish, was maybe still in school when this came out. I've never heard of this girl before. Really beautiful vocal arrangements going on in the background there. There's a very Celtic kind of vibe, and you know, I'm a Northern Ireland here, so you know, I've definitely heard lots of Irish music in my time. Very folk, Celtic kind of sound. I don't know. When I seen the title of this, Runaway, I actually, part of me assumed it was going to be a cover of the Bon Jovi song, maybe just done in a different way, but you know, nothing to do with Bon Jovi so far from what I can tell. I love the sparseness to this production, you know, really nice video as well. I'm kind of catching glimpses of the video, if I'm being honest with you, because the music has got its own world so much that I actually, do you know what? I actually kind of feel an urge to close my eyes and just, you know, a lot of the time, you know, that's what music makes me want to do, you know, and that's a compliment to the music here, you know? So, anyway, the visuals look very, very nice, but the music is just beautiful. Kind of curious to see where this is going to go.
Climbing my way.
Very Celtic.
I saw a piece of heaven waiting in patience for me. And I was running far away. Would I run off the world someday? Nobody knows, nobody knows. And I was dancing in the rain. I felt alive and I can't complain. But no, take me home where I belong. I can't take it anymore.
Wow. Beautifully dynamic singing there. This is very rare for me. I can actually feel as I'm listening to this, I'm holding my breath. It sounds like a bit of a cheesy thing to say. I don't know if I've ever said this before, but it's not much music that I've heard that actually takes my breath away. There's something breathtaking about this, and I'm not just saying that as a superlative. You know, physically, I could actually feel myself holding my breath there, you know, to really listen in. She's really captivating me and really pulling me in. It's really beautiful. Some really haunting piano sounds and stuff in there as well. Let's keep it moving.
I can't take it anymore.
That's lovely.
I was painting a picture. Was a painting of you, and for a moment I thought you were here, but then again it wasn't true.
I must say the production of the song is reminding me a little bit of Olafur Arnalds. it's got a very Scandinavian, sparse kind of feel to it, you know, with sort of, with sounds that don't sound like typical instruments, you know. It almost sounds like spoons or something there, metallic kind of, you know, that have been sampled in there. I love that, you know, you're getting a really cinematic, otherworldly kind of vibe of what's going on. I'm loving the really deep down vocals. I mean, who's providing those? I mean, is that her voice way, way down there? It sounds really deep. Did you hear my stomach rumbling there? Might be time for something to eat.
And all this time I have been lying, oh, lying in secret to myself. I've been putting sorrow on the forest place on my shelf. La-dee-da. And I was running far away. Would I run off the world someday? Nobody knows, nobody knows.
Beautiful vocal harmonies.
I was dancing in the rain.
Good, so dynamic. I know I keep saying dynamic, but it's really refreshing to hear, you know, modern day. I mean, look how many views is on this. You know, this is the reason why I haven't heard of her is because, you know, she's not the sort of typical thing that I would listen to. You know, I'm not sure what genre this falls under. Like, I mean, it's obviously popular, and it's not like pop music, and then like Britney Spears or something like that. But when I say popular, I mean just popular, you know, lots of people listen to it. I haven't heard of her until now, but obviously a lot of other people have heard of her. She's obviously a bit of a sensation. A couple of other artists that kind of came to mind listening to her was Bjork. Not necessarily that she sounds like Bjork, but I don't know, there's something. Despite it having lots of views, there's something almost anti-mainstream about it that strikes me. It's kind of quirky, you know. It's offbeat, it's eclectic, all those kind of words. It's catchy. Obviously, the song is the type of thing that, you know, once you've heard it, you know, I haven't even heard the whole song yet, and I can, you know, there's an earworm, you know. I can remember the chorus as it was, so it's very recognizable. But the production is very ethereal, not typical, you know. I love the fact that there's not just some big trap beat or something stuck in on this. Trap beats are cool and all the rest of it, but this, I just love the fact that everything is way in the background, you know, with the piano sounds, and even a lot of the background is being provided by her voice, presumably. Enya was another one. You know, Enya's going back a little bit now, but just Enya vibes. Modern day Enya.
I can't take it anymore. But I kept running for a soft place to fall. And I kept running.
Just realized I didn't finish that thought. I was saying about the dynamic thing. So much of today's music is overly compressed. You know, I don't want to get into like a whole big debate about it. Like, but when songs are mastered, you know, they're crushed, you know, so the dynamics are usually squeezed out of them to compete with loudness, so that when you listen to it on your phone or whatever, you don't need to turn it up. It just hits you, you know. It's a whole debate on mastering, you know. Anyway, I don't want to get into that, you know. I'm quite happy to talk about it sometime if you want me to, because I do have opinions on it. But to me, it's really refreshing to hear current music that has a very big production, but doesn't sound so squeezed of dynamics. Her vocals are really dynamic on that, you know, so top class production, you know.
And I kept running for a soft place to fall. And I kept running for a soft place.
soft place to fall, and I kept running for a soft place to fall. And I was running far away. Would I run off the world someday? But no, take me home.
So weird to me when we send a trap beat. There's a trap beat in there. A trap beat actually works here. But it's subdued, isn't it? And the hi-hats we do hear it. It's done in a way that it's not that obvious. It does work. It's weird.
Someday.
To it, I don't think it needs it, you know. I guess it was like a trending kind of thing, you know, the last sort of 5 or 6 years or whatever. You know, there's been a lot of bands that have been, you know, using this trap beat. And one of my favorite bands, Polyphia, you know, they're like instrumental kind of guys, you know, all guitar music. They've incorporated it in a way that I really like. But you know, usually in the mix, that you know, the fast hi-hat thing, you know, is at such a high level in the mix that to me it's just distracting. And actually, if I'm being perfectly honest, it is distracting me here, which it shouldn't be doing. You know, why? I don't know if it really needs to be there. The groove works. The groove is brilliant. But now that my ear is being pulled to the... I don't know. To me, that's getting in the way of her vocal. And I would much rather that the vocals are, you know, hitting me. It's far better to listen to. I don't know. I'm not quite completely sure on it.
Take me home where I belong. I got no other place to go. No, take me home. Take me home where I belong. I got no other place to go. No, take me home.
Everything else just seems to be so perfectly worked out, you know, with a synthesized da-da-da-da-da, the arpeggios and you know, in the left channel here. Really like that. And all the percussion, everything else, and all the vocals. Love the mix. Just that, I don't know. It's pulling me out a little bit.
I got no other place to go. No, take me home. Home where I belong. Oh, no, no, no. Take me home. Home where I belong. Oh, oh, oh. No, take me home. Home where I belong. Oh, no, no, no. Take me home. Home where I belong. I can't take it anymore.
Yeah, beautiful. Particularly at the end there with those vocals that do sound like male backing vocals to me. They're at such a sort of low range. But you never know, you know. There's a lot of singers out here with very big ranges, you know. They can go from very high notes to very low notes. So I'm not sure, but, you know, it sounded like a male voice filling those out. So anyway, this was something different. You know, if you have a look around my channel, you see a lot of the stuff I've done is sort of metal stuff. Not all of it, though. So have a look around in the reaction videos. I also have my own music on there and some piano performances because I'm a classical piano teacher. That's my main job. And I also write and record music as well. So anyway, really like this one. Completely different. And yeah, so see you all again next time. Thanks for watching.